Hey, welcome to the Backwoods Gourmet. Today we're going to make homemade bread and we're going to bake it in a brand new, still got a tag, Lodge cast iron loaf pan, and we're going to bake it on the Weber Kettle Grill. Y'all stay tuned. So, I literally just picked this up at Bass Pro Shops. I was there this morning. I can't walk out of that store without spending much money. I seen this guy here, and I'm like, you know, we've been baking bread. We've been doing it in the little 8-inch camp-made Dutch oven I did the other day. I think I finally got it down. So, I thought about, okay, like you guys, you get this brand new. Okay, brand new. We're not going to do anything to it. We're not going to sand it. We're not going to polish it. We're going to leave it as is. All we're going to do is grease the inside of it and put our bread loaf in there. And, you know, we don't do anything inside. I've got 214 videos at this point in time. And I don't think you guys have watched me make anything inside yet. So what we're going to do, we're going to fire that Weber Kettle Grill up. We're going to get that bad boy up to about 400 indirect. Gonna put this guy right in the middle and bake off a nice homemade loaf of bread. If you try it, it's gonna be awesome.
So these are the very few simple ingredients that you're gonna need to make homemade bread. Right here I have a teaspoon of sugar, maybe a little less. I have one packet of yeast. I am using a Red Star champagne yeast. I've had really good luck with this. Okay, I bought this on Amazon. I'll try to find the link, leave that down in the description box for you. Got 1 teaspoon of kosher sea salt, 1 tablespoon of cooking oil. I've got some warm water here, about 100, 105 degrees, and 2 cups of bread flour. So first thing we're gonna do is, and of course we got our cast iron, our brand new cast iron pan right there. Go ahead and get that out of the way. Oh, and last but not least, we got some lard, real lard. I'm gonna use that just to grease our pan. So we'll put them over there. And then the first thing we're gonna do is bloom these yeast. And I'm gonna show you how to do that real quick. So I'm gonna take my sugar and put it right here in the bowl. And then I'm gonna pour in couple tablespoons of the warm water, just a couple, and I'm going to swirl that around and dissolve it. We'll give it a few minutes to completely dissolve.
There it goes. You guys seen that, right?
Alright, so now that our yeast has bloomed and we know it's good to go, there's our 1/4 teaspoon of salt, or that's 1 teaspoon of salt, or a tablespoon of oil. It's gonna help make your bread tender. Gonna go ahead and give that just a little stir around. Get this process started. In goes our nice foamy yeast. Try to get all them in there. And then warm water, 100, 105 degrees. Gonna add it a little bit at a time. Start bringing it together. real quick, guys, I wanted to show you our brand new merch from Teespring there. They got the Backwoods Gourmet logo on the front and on the back. You probably can't see that, but it says Cast Iron Crew. That's our official membership t-shirt from here from Backwoods Gourmet. Got a bunch more designs coming. Actually just launched one yesterday with the Dutch oven on it. And I want you guys to click the link down right below the description box. Check that one out. I think you'll get a nice laugh out of it. And it'll be a great, great item to wear when you're Dutch oven cooking.
Hey guys, let's go in. It's been about an hour, 15 minutes. Let's go in and take a look. Yep, it's puffing up real nice. It's about time to get her out of the bowl, give it another little working, and get it over there in that brand new Lodge loaf pan for the second rise. All right, we got a clean, dry surface. Just gonna go ahead and sprinkle a little flour in here. Get some flour on my hand here, and we're gonna scrape it out. Pull it out of the bowl. It's gonna stick a little bit. Don't worry around that, unless you oil your bowl. I find that's not really necessary. So we got it out, get it on some flour. Just gonna start folding it into itself. All right, it's puffed up pretty good. It's really stretchy. Okay, we're gonna punch it down. Keep just rolling it onto itself. You don't have to over knead this, because the more you knead it, the tougher it's going to get. The more you're going to stretch those glutens in the flour out. So we don't want to over knead it and make it tough. We want this to be a really light. So we got a brand new, right from the store, cast iron out. I'm just going to put some of this lard on my fingers. I'm going to rub that entire pan. We did rinse this out with a little bit of water and a little bit of soap. And I want to get all the top surfaces too, because this might just rise up over the top of this. So that's pretty good. It's nice and greased. So let's go back into our loaf here. We're going to try to get it into loaf size. Like that. Tuck the ends up under. Stretch it if you want to. Kind of layer in there. And pat it down a little bit. Put the towel back over. Let it rise a little longer. And then we'll slice the top. All right, guys, well, there is our loaf. It has risen up above the top of the pan. So let's go check on
our fire. All right, guys, we're getting the Weber Kettle Grill ready for bacon. We got a full chimney, Kingsford, or I'm knocking everything over here. Kingsford. It's Kingsford original. And now it's like a hot, all right. One on each side of the grill, half on one side, half on the other. Gonna put our grill in there. Go ahead and get our lid. We got the bottom full open. So we're probably gonna have to crank back a little bit, and we're gonna open the top full open. We're looking for about 400 to 450 degrees.
So that baby's sitting at 400. That's where we want it. Indirect, okay? Both sides coals, none in the middle. All right, so here comes our loaf, right in the center. A little piece of thread from the towel on it. All right, let's get the lid on. And you want to orient your vent down the middle also. About halfway through this cooking time, short time, I'm going to switch it around the other way. Guys, so the last 5 minutes, let's put the lid over here. That's sitting right on 400, by the way. I put my teeny little, tiny little Lodge in there with some butter in it. And you see that loaf. I'm going to go ahead and just baste the top with butter. All
Tell you what, a pretty good looking piece of bread right there. In about another 2 or 3 minutes, you're ready to come off. Off, let's see if it comes out of our little new brand new lodge. Oh, look at that. Okay, that's perfect. Perfect. Just pulled right, I just lifted it right out of there. Let's take a good slice, see how it looks inside. Again, sorry guys for sniffling, but allergy season. Thanks for watching Backwoods Gourmet. If you like what we're doing, hit that like button right down there. If you'd like to subscribe to our channel, you can do it right here for another great Backwoods Gourmet video. It's going to be right up there. And for a whole playlist of cooking on the Weber Kettle Grill, it's going to be right up there. We'll see you next time.